Hello guys, welcome back to the channel. On today's video, we are installing this strut brace into the rear of the E36 M3. It's a quick install, so follow me so you can learn how to do it. If you haven't subscribed to the channel, please make sure that you do and like this content if you like this type of, you know, review. Browse to the channel to see what I have done, you know, to this car, that one right there, and the Mini Cooper outside. Again, this channel is about these three cars for now, and I also have Crippen's car, which is the 335 convertible. We are working on that. I'm filming, but I haven't posted those one yet. So stay tuned and make sure they subscribe, like, to promote this channel and help me grow. As you guys already know, I have one strut brace on the front of the car. Now, that strut brace is working perfectly. Right now, I purchased this Megan Racing strut brace. It's not really too expensive for the rear of the car. Again, this is in pursuit of me making sure that my car is ready for a track day this summer. Now, what exactly do you need is a strut brace. Now, a strut brace, depending on what it does, it connects the shocks from one side of the car and the other side of the car. That's why it goes from one side to the other, because it connects them so that whenever you have any type of pressure and, you know, or force coming from the ground or cornering, whatever, it's being transferred to both shocks. Instead of one shock taking all the heat, both of them we kind of take some of it, right? So this one will take maybe 60%, and then the other one is going to take like 40%. It helps in the rigidity of the car and make sure, and it helps to make sure that the car is, you know, tight. It doesn't really balance too much when you're cornering. That's why we actually purchased these and installed those in the car. Now, this one is going to the car, and it's pretty simple. It's as far as just removing the bolt, placing this, and bolting everything on the back. So I kind of opened this box already. So let me do like a little quick unboxing, even though that the box is already open. Just I wanted to see how it looks like. So this is how it's packaged. And yeah, looking really nice. So as you can see, this end will connect to one shock absorber, and then the other side here will connect to the other one. And yeah, that's it. Let's now move to the back and install this. And I'm just gonna go ahead and put that right here and prep the car. We are now in the trunk of the car, and I went ahead and, you know, removed the plastic wrap on the strut brace. This is pretty much how it looks like. Now this end is gonna be here, and then this end is going to be there. And you have that Megan Racing logo right here. The first thing that we have to do is remove this carpet cover thing here, because the bolt that we want to access are under here. Same thing on this side, so the bolt will be under here, so we have to remove all of this. And pretty much what I'm going to do, because in the future we'll be upgrading my shocks, is I'm just going to go ahead and cut a hole here so that in the future I don't have to remove this little cover. And same thing here, so in the future we have an opening here, just because in the future I just want to come here and kind of unbolt and, you know, go ahead and go about my business. So let me go ahead and remove these two so that I will expose the bolt and then show you the next step. I am halfway done removing everything and cutting, and this is pretty much where I am. So I have a bit of rust here that I think I have to address later on. See, I just found that out. But this is the piece. After you remove this cover, you have this extra cover also here. So I just kind of cut here, and then what I'm going to do next is use this cover. This cover is actually for this side right here, and I'm going to kind of cut on the top here also for that side. As you can see, it's kind of looking okay on here, so I have to cut it the same area but on this cover or the floor right here. So that's what I'm going to do next. I'm going to show you how everything it is done once I have everything with these covers installed, and then I have like a hole like this here. Then I'll go ahead and mount this brace. I just use a regular scissor to cut it. It's not that heavy. Okay, I am done. I remove everything and place it back, as you can see. Now, this is the hole. I mean, it's not perfect looking, but it's fine with me. This is the street truck car, so I don't really care. And that's the hole on that side. So next time I'm working here, I will not have to remove this protective shield carpet thing. I just, you know, access to the bolt straight up there, and then the bolt straight up there. Now, if you have one of the E36 or E46, you definitely have to invest in reinforcement plate here, because this area is weak, especially when you have aftermarket shocks absorbers or coilovers. Now, this right here kind of give a first level, but I definitely want to invest in a good set of, you know, strut support right here. Now, that's gonna come in the future, definitely. But for now, I just have to remove one 13 millibolt bolt here, one there,
and two also on that side, and then go ahead and mount this in there and then retorque everything, and that should be it. Let me go ahead and install everything and then show you the finished product. Here's the finished product. Looking nice. Let me go ahead and just remove this little wrapping paper so that I have the whole shiny piece. Now, one thing that you have to also make sure you do is when you are mounting this, make sure that you release the handbrake. When you release the handbrake, you have a little more availability here, because when you install it, it's kind of not perfectly aligned, but once you release the handbrake, then it becomes aligned and then you can easily drop it. This took me like 5 minutes just to mount this whole thing and tight everything together. Yep, this is it. Now the final piece is make sure that you tight these also. Mine are not tight right now, as you can see. I'm gonna go ahead and tight those. So again, this is it. Now installation is pretty fairly simple. Now, how do you like this, man? If you like this type of content, make sure that you subscribe to the channel. There's a lot of content like this. And again, this is my project car. I have to fix this. And yeah, I'm doing all of this to make sure that it is ready for a truck day. I want to take it on the truck, but there's still a little few things that I have to do to ensure that it is ready. So I guess on this note, thank you for watching, and make sure that you subscribe, and see you on the next video. Thank you.